future.
Hidamari Ga Kikoeru. I hear the sunspot. It's based on the manga of the same name, which is a yaoi manga series written and illustrated by Yuko Fumino. Synopsis. Due to his hearing disability, Kohei Shikawara is often misunderstood and has trouble integrating into his life on campus. As such, he keeps his distance. That all changes when he meets the outspoken and cheerful Tachi Sagawa. He comforts Kohei and assures him that his hearing loss is not his fault. Tachi's kind words cut through Kohei's usual defense mechanisms and open his heart. Now they're more than friends and less than lovers. Even so, this relationship changes Kohei forever. Hello everyone, this is Siu Piu Chu, and I'm going to be trying out a new concept called film sketch. This is where I sketch scenes from a movie that I've watched and talk about the aspect of it I find most interesting. The film today is I Hear the Sunspots. I read the manga before I discovered that a live action of it actually existed. Curious, I watched it. It was sweet, simple, and a decent film overall. As always, the manga was 1,000 times better, but I went back and watched the film again, and it was brilliant. Only till I watched it again, I noticed all the details and how deep each scene actually was. The film portrayed the manga's theme beautifully with only a 72-minute runtime. The film alone, without any relation to the manga, was pretty good, with how it wrapped up the story while still fleshing out the characters. However, I'm not going to be gushing about how good I thought the film was. Instead, I'm going to be gushing about how good I thought Tachi was. Tachi, in the live action, is a character who demonstrates acceptance and understanding in various situations throughout the film. He's someone we can all learn from, especially when it comes to connecting to people who are different from us. I'm going to be drawing scenes that I feel best convey Tachi and Kohei's relationship, highlighting Tachi's actions which show understanding and acceptance, but other things I find pretty neat. Kohei Shikawara wakes up. This is 8th grade Kohei in the summer before high school. He's been resting for the past few days because of high fevers. Kohei stares out the window. He realizes that everything has suddenly become quiet. Now there's nothing but silence. It's a cold and quiet morning. He then hopes to hear something warm, like the sunshine. Introducing Tachi Sagawa on the left. He's a college student who's very poor and in desperate need for a part-time job. He can't even afford a meal as of now. Then, he sees a note-taker job opening on his university billboard and decides to apply for it. And on the right is his buddy. He kind of becomes relevant later on. A few seconds after this scene, we're introduced to grown-up college student pretty boy Kohei, attending the same uni as Tachi. I like this moment. This is the first time he notices Tachi even without knowing it. As Tachi and his friends pass by him, he hears Tachi's voice briefly, loud and clearly. Then he's left wondering why he heard it so well. Here, we learn a little bit more about Tachi as he sits and talks with his friend. We learn that Tachi's voice is really loud and that it actually got him fired from his previous job. Then we also learn another reason he got fired was that he stood up against the customers that were disrespectful, and that shows us that he's got a huge sense of justice. Tachi is walking around starving. He stops and sits against a hand railing, pondering about food. Suddenly, he loses his balance and falls over on the ground on his back. He then spots pretty boy Kohei sitting alone at the tree eating lunch. This scene shows how lonely Kohei is. For someone who you think would be popular, he's sitting alone, isolated, far from anyone else. Tachi, hungry, immediately rushes to Kohei, excited by the lunch Kohei is eating. To his surprise, Kohei hands over his lunch without saying a word, exuding a cool guy aura as he does. Tachi sees that Kohei is actually a nice guy, despite the rumors about him being cold and distant. This changes Tachi's impression of him. Now, to Kohei's surprise, the next day Tachi meets him again at the tree. However, this time Tachi pulls out a flyer from his bag, which is about the note-taker job. He says that he'll agree to their job if he can get a bento in exchange, so Kohei's lunches. The reason why Kohei needs a note-taker is because sometimes he can't hear parts of the lecture or the main points. Then, this is the first official start of their relationship. Kohei now realizes that it was Tachi's voice that he had heard so clearly. When Tachi's friend asks him if he finds Kohei annoying to deal with, Tachi whips around and flat out tells his friend, "No, it's not," and not to make assumptions without knowing Kohei first. Tachi stands up for Kohei. Even though it's much easier to agree, he doesn't go along with others' wrong assumptions. He corrects them because he cares. He took time to understand Kohei. He knows Kohei doesn't deserve it. Their time spent together was fun and they get along incredibly well. This day, Kohei forgot to bring Tachi's lunch, so they head to the cafeteria. I find this part so annoying. Kohei's fangirls show up and surround him, blocking him from Tachi. They start bombarding Kohei with sign language, asking him if he wants to eat with them. Kohei, in fact, does not know sign language, but he can lip read. Kohei, visibly annoyed and frustrated, literally walks away. I did some reading on deaf etiquette, and its first rule is, don't assume, just ask. There are different degrees of deafness and different ways to communicate with someone who is hearing impaired or deaf. Those fangirls just made their own assumptions. They never talked to Kohei like a normal person and asked what he's comfortable with. Whereas Tachi, despite knowing about Kohei's hearing, approaches him just like he would with any of his other friends. Then, two douchebag guys show up. They see Kohei walking away from the girls. They think he's being arrogant and start talking trash behind his back because they're like, he can't hear us. But you know who can hear them? Tachi. Tachi freaking throws a punch at one of the dudes and straight out starts brawling with them. Then Kohei turns to look behind him. He's shook. Kohei takes Tachi away from the fight. They stop at a picnic bench. Kohei, upset, asks Tachi why he beat those guys up when it had nothing to do with him. Tachi looks straight at him and says, "The ability not to hear is not your fault." Kohei has an epiphany with a sense of relief that finally someone gets him. Tachi goes on to say that why should he always have to be considered others? Others should be considerate of him too. Kohei starts to cry. Now, in the summer before high school, when Kohei had his high fevers, his mother took him to go see the doctors. They ended up finding out that due to the fevers, he ended up having severe hearing loss. And then, once he entered high school, it didn't get better at all. In this scene, we transition back to a flashback of Kohei in high school. This is an important part because this is where he starts to build up his walls. In this scene, Kohei walks up to a group of guys in his class. They have a conversation and Kohei asks for one of them to repeat themselves. The guy he asks gets so annoyed and tells Kohei to get lost, all because he couldn't bear to repeat himself. From this instance, Kohei completely starts to lose confidence and starts to feel like a burden. Then some girl from his class even comes up to him and tells him that he's boring now, all due to his hearing loss that he couldn't help. Now, we return back to the present, at the picnic bench. This moment is so sweet, I might even get a cavity. Kohei and Tachi talk for a bit, then Kohei starts to cheer up a bit and starts to laugh a little. Tachi points out that this is his first time he's seen him laugh and that he looks much better with a smile. This is where Kohei starts to realize his feelings for Tachi. Kohei even starts to learn how to make Tachi's bento, his lunch, from his mom, and makes both for himself and Tachi then. Then, Tachi's buddy, which I mentioned earlier, comes up to Tachi and tells him that his friend, which is a girl, is interested and wants to go on a date with them. The girl and Tachi meet at a cafe, but she's actually interested in Kohei and wants to ask Tachi how to get closer to him. She brings up Kohei's hearing impairment and she goes on about how it's like a love story in a book she read where the handsome male lead is deaf and the hearing takes care of him with the power of her love. Tachi, rightfully, gets super annoyed. He says to her that Kohei is perfectly capable and he's his own person, not a storybook character. Tachi doesn't try to make out Kohei to be some fictional character as a way to understand him. He takes Kohei the way he is. Then, we cut to Kohei and Tachi sitting together in an empty classroom. Kohei reviewing the notes Tachi took for him, and Tachi opening his usual bento. Aww, Kohei is simping so hard for Tachi. It's so freaking cute. He gets excited like a puppy because this time he made Tachi's lunch, but Tachi doesn't know that. Tachi says it's delicious and Kohei gets super happy. He then realizes and tries to calm down quickly. Let's give a big warm welcome to Mr. Miscommunication. While walking in the rain, Tachi's friend runs into Kohei. He tells Kohei what the girl Tachi met, her true intentions were, and that Tachi was really upset after meeting her. Kohei misinterprets this and he thinks that Tachi likes the girl and that he's getting in the way between them. Then, Kohei, devastated, texts Tachi that the note-taker partnership is over and he doesn't have to see him anymore. Tachi then discovers what his friend had told Kohei. Realizing the misunderstanding, he goes to Kohei's house to clear things up. Unfortunately, Kohei is at home, so he meets his mom instead. Kohei's mom tells Tachi that Kohei actually made his lunches and talks about him a lot. Before Tachi leaves, Kohei's mom stops him and says, "Can you always stay with Kohei?" Little did she know. Tachi, tired of searching for Kohei, takes a seat. His friend once again comes along and asks, "What's up?" Tachi basically explains how much he admires Kohei and that he can't just leave him by himself. He can't leave things the way they are. Oh, and would you look at that? Tachi's friend turns around to see Kohei behind them, overhearing the whole conversation. Tachi then sees him too. Kohei walks over and returns Tachi's phone, which he forgot at his house. Kohei then walks away quickly. Tachi chases after him. Tachi confronts Kohei, saying Kohei should express his feelings. Kohei tells him that he wouldn't understand them. Tachi, being the angel that he is, says that even if he doesn't understand anything now, he'll make an effort to, little by little. But he can't if Kohei doesn't say anything. Tachi also clears up the misunderstanding too, why he really was upset. Tachi grabs onto Kohei, telling him to just say what he wants to say and not to give up on himself. Tachi starts to cry. And then slowly, Kohei leans into Tachi and kisses him. Tachi then realizes Kohei's true feelings towards him. After some time passes between them without them seeing each other, Tachi once again meets Kohei at the same tree from when they first met. Kohei never thought Tachi would ever come to see him again. Then, Tachi explains that no matter how much he thought about it, he couldn't find any reason to hate him. Tachi then cheerfully pulls out the flyer, the same flyer for the note-taker job, and asks if it's still available. Kohei, stunned, stares back at him in silence. Then, Tachi asks, "Can you hear me?" And then Kohei replies, "I can hear you loud and clear." Aww, I felt like at the end it was Tachi's way of accepting Kohei, saying let's start our new relationship over again. In conclusion, what Tachi did differently compared to all the other characters is in fact something so simple. He treated Kohei as he would treat anyone else. He treated him normally and didn't change his behavior based over assumptions about his impairment. He treated him based on the way he is, not on his hearing. So, let's all find a little Tachi inside of us. Thank you.